Hello everyone. So in this video, I'm going to show you how we can fetch the data from Google Sheet to the MIT App Inventor app. So I'm going to show you a step-by-step everything here. So here we go. So first of all, click on the new project and my project name is Google Sheet Data New. So that's our app here. So let's design the app. Okay. So what I'm going to do here, I'm going to just simply use here the layout, and that is the vertical arrangement. Okay. So just drag and drop it and make this hide and where this fill parent like this. And now we need to use here, click on user interface, and we need to use here the one button, one text box, and one list view. Okay. So whenever someone click on this button and wherever someone put their any roll number, so we'll fetch that particular number or roll number information, ID number to that list view. Okay. So how we can do this? So it's simple. Let's click on the vertical arrangement and make this all this thing in a center like this. Okay, or make it the vertical should be the top. Now I need one simple label to make some space between this like this. Okay, and click on vertical arrangement and change that background color to pink or something. Change that text to enter number or enter ID, something like this. Now for that button, I just say here, get data. I'm going to make it the 18, and I'm going to make that width is at least 70%, like this. Change that default color to the something else. Okay, purple, but I'm going to just change the text color to white. That's great. Now we have the list also. Here we'll fetch all the data, okay? I'm going to make that text box width is also 70%, so it's look aligned. Cool. Okay. I'm going to change that screen name to the Google or student data. Okay. Like this. Now we have that simple design. In the left side, you will see, click on just user interface again, and you will see here one is connectivity. Okay. In this connectivity, we just need to drag and drop that web component like this simply, and it's done. Okay. Now let's create a Google Sheet. Click on the blank spreadsheet and just use your username. You can put any name, and I have already have one data, so I'm going to just use that data, okay, in the sheet and just paste it here. Okay. You just need to put, make sure the roll number that should be in the first row, and the data you can put in the any row, it's not, doesn't matter, but I'm going to just put the ID here, okay, because I'm going to go to write the code according to this. Now, we need to share that file. So click on share. And as you can see here, this is untitled. So, and save it. Okay. And you can see the restricted. Click on this. And anyone with this link, click on this. And this should be the view only. And click on copy link. And just done. Okay. Or, you can do one more thing. You can just make it edit also. Okay. And just copy link. And done. Okay, now go to the any editor, okay, here, and just paste that link. Now, as you can see here, this link have the edit and the sharing option. We need to make that link like this. As you can see, this I already have created. That should be export, okay? So make sure after that ID, you can see the edit and question mark, remove that thing, okay? And after the slash, we need to type export. Okay, as you can see at this export question mark, then format equal CSV like this, and just copy this thing. Okay, now go to the MIT App Inventor, click on web and paste it. That's it. Now let's go to the block section. Okay, now first of all, we need to create two lists. So click on list, create empty list. So I'm going to use the variable, and this is the here. And you can just put the number, or you can just put the ID and just copy paste and just say here, you can just say here data or global data like this. Once people click on that button, button one, we need to call this web API. So that we need to call that web, okay, that URL. So just scroll down and you will see here the web get this one we need to call. After calling this, okay, that URL will call, but once you call this, so that will in the app will fetch that data in our CSV file, okay? And we need to fetch that CSV file data to our list, to somewhere. So how we can get all the data? So for that, we need to use your one method. Click on the web and you'll see the option of got text. As you can see, got text, okay? Because we are getting the text, okay? Now, once we got the text, so first of all, we need to use that number, this one list, and we need to get all the data in this list, okay? How we can get that? Click on the list and you will see here the list from CSV table text. List from, you can see, just scroll down and see list from CSV table, this one, okay? Table text, here. And we need to get the content, response content, this one. Once we call this, we got a response, okay? And once we got a response, we will get that response in that list, number list, okay? Now, we need to create one procedure. So I'm going to just call it procedure, this one. And in this procedure, what I'm going to do here, I need to call here the loop, because when I get the list, so I need to add all the data in my list one by one, okay? So how can I do this? So simply, I can use here the control and you will see here the option of for each loop, this one, okay? Just call it here. And this is the item and which list we need to get? We need to get the number list, okay? Because we have saved our data in this list, like this. First of all, whenever we request it, because we click on the button one and we've put some text on here because we are fetching by ID. So we need to check this ID is correct or not, okay? So for each global number, we have data and we'll call here that if condition, use control and call it if, like this. We need to compare the data. So click on the maths and you will see the equal sign, call it here. And which data we need to compare? We need to compare text box one dot text data. From which we need to compare this by this ID. It means this ID is one ID, right? This is the first row and first column, right? First. So go to the MIT App Inventor here. And we need to just simply just say here, click on the list and just get the data. Select list item list. Select, just go here, select list item list, this one, okay? We need to select, we are selecting the item. And from which list we need to select item? Which list? We are selecting item from that global number, but we have the item, this one. So we are getting the, reading the row data. Like this row we read, right, first. So in that row, we have the one data is, one is this. So we'll get the index value one. If I will just use here the two. So if you want to compare text box one dot text data with that name, so you need to use two. If you want to compare that data by mobile number, you need to put 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, you need to put 5. But I'm gonna use here the one because I'm comparing the data from that one, that ID, okay? And this is the first column. Simple. If it's correct, then we need to fetch the whole data from that row. So simply, after fetching data, we need to add to the list because we have created the list. So you can see the list and you will see the add item to the list like this. And in which list we need to add item? So we already have created the list of data. Get data. In this list, we need to select item, add item. Which item we need to add? So we need to add the, again, simply is that select list item. Okay, this one, call it here. Okay. And this is the item. This is not one, this is two. Simply. So what we will get? We will get Harry. Okay. Now what I'm going to do here, I'm going to add one text. Okay. And in the text, I'm going to use here the join. I'll call it here. After this, I've joined this one. So I'm going to call that, there is the name. And here I'm going to call just simple text. And that text name is name and comma, like this. Okay. Column name, and that will select the name, and name is Harry. Same thing we need to repeat. Simply, we have multiple data, so like copy, paste, 3, 4 item. So we have fetched the name, then what's that? This is the city, age and number. So I'm going to put here city, age, and number. Like this, age and city. But we need to change the index also to 3, 4, and 5. That's it. Now we need to call this procedure. Wait a second, okay? Now we need to call this procedure. So how can I call this? So it's really simple. Click on procedure and gives you that is the procedure. Call it here. But after this, we need to add all the things, all the item, all the list data to our list that we have displayed. Here, this is the list view one. So how can I do this? So set list view dot element, this one. Call it here. After this, and from which list we need to set? Global data, this one. Right? So that is our all app. Okay, let's go to the design. Let's change some design. I want to just change something in the design. So I'm going to add that label here. We have added. I'm going to just change that height to the 5% here. And I'm going to add one more label, okay, to make that design good. Change the text and make it height is also 3% or something like this. Okay, so let's click on the connect. Let's click on the AI companion. Use the code. I have the App Inventor. Just put the code here and click on connect. Enter ID, okay? So I'm going to put the ID. You can just change that, you know, with all that text box or font size, you can make it 20. So that will automatically change, suppose, yes. Now click on the enter ID. So what's the ID here? This is the 777, okay? So let's try that 777. Click on get data. See, name Harry, city London, age 22, number this. That's really amazing, right? Now, if you want to fetch someone else data, 778, click on get data. Oh, TCB this. So I want to fetch the only one data. So how can I remove the first one? So for that, we simply use here the loop. It's simple. Like, I'm going to call it the for each loop, but I'm going to create one procedure. Click on this procedure, okay, here. And you can see, we'll call, click on the list, and you'll see the remove list. Hit this item. And from which list we need to remove item? From the data list, we need to remove the item. And make sure that index should be only one, not the other. That's it. Okay? Now let's try this. But when I try this, okay? So whenever I run my app first time, so that data is also empty. So when I run this app first time, so that data already empty. Okay? So that will give us the error. How we can control this? So I'm going to call first the procedure here. Okay, this procedure. So I'm going to delete data. That's my procedure name. Okay, so I'm going to call this procedure on the button click. But that will give me the error. So to remove that error, what I'm going to do here, I'm going to simply do one thing here, that I'm going to use the control and use the if. Okay, simply this, and I'm going to call logic and do it here. Click on the list, and you'll see here the is list empty. And which list is the data list? This one, and that should be true. So I'm going to just use the type that true like this, get it here. If that data is empty in the list, so we'll call only the get data. But else, if data is not empty, then we'll call the first delete. And then web get data. That's it. Okay. That's the overall code that we have written. So let's try this, how this will work. AI companion. I'm using this here. It's a old. Try 777. Click on get data. You can see the Harry London. Let's try this 778. Get data. So it said that it's a invalid list. Okay, no problem. Wait a second. You can see the from 2 to 5, I'm going to need to 4 because we have the only 4 item, right? Simply click on get data again. It's done. Let's try it 779. Click on get data. And we have any, right? 777. Let's try get data. So we'll fetch only one data at one time. It's really amazing thing. Okay. So if you have any doubt, you can ask me in comment. Thank you so much for watching this video. Have a nice day. Be safe. Bye-bye.